guys. So what's going to happen here is that first cut, right? I was able to put this panel in there. Now what I'm going to do is this gets...
You can see that.
See this? All right, there's a tool, the same tool that makes the holes. The other side of it makes that flange. Okay, so it basically makes a flange like that. So now I made a sample of it on one side, a sample of it on the other side, and now we know where it's gonna sit, right? So this and this like that, this goes in here, okay? That's gonna go like that. We laid a piece of tape out so that flange, that metal is gonna sit
inside.
It's gonna sit like that in there. So it'll sit like just like that, right? And it'll be flush, and then I'll weld it. So right now, recut this and then stamp that whole thing all the way down the side. I'll show you when I'm doing that, but I'm gonna make a nice cut here again and recut this nice and clean, and that'll make it so it'll be perfect.
Cut off now.
Gotta clean this in. You wanna make sure the edge is nice and clean or it won't sit.
Now.
Let's see how this works.
Okay.
So I got that all stamped down.
Now you can put it in there.
Here. Try to keep it as long as you could because it's got to get rewelded there.
And then it'll fit in like that.
There we go. Now, when that goes like that, and then that's going to go like that.
And you got a little gap you can fill in with the welder.
So now, let's see, I might have to trim it back up. Let's see in a minute. So that's going to go there. And that. And this. Like that. So. Now at least it's flush, you know, and then minimal work.
You don't have to grind the whole weld down.
Well, you still got to grind the weld, but at least it's not. The whole thing ain't sticking
yeah.
off, you know what I mean? We're going to grind it all down nice and clean. Make sure this
half the grinding work if you were going to do weld it.
But more importantly, it comes out clean. So I'm going to just trim this a hair right there. And that's that. All right, guys. So I got the panel all cut, flanged, and it's all prepped. And I just realized something. I'm going to check now, but I think this is galvanized. I hope it isn't. God, I hope this isn't galvanized. Because galvanized sucks the weld. So I'm going to take this other half of it that I cut off and just run a little bead on it real quick and see how it goes. All right, so we got that all clamped down tight, and then we're gonna just move along. I'm gonna weld, I'm gonna tack it in a couple spots, and then we'll go back and weld it all. I'm gonna spot weld all those spots, and it should be perfect. Tack it all up first. Gotta find my glasses. All right, here we go. Like a rock. Thank you. what I'm doing is I'm welding it in sections all the way down and then skipping and going back and forth until it's totally welded, one big long weld. But I don't want to get it too hot. So weld a little bit here and then go down the other end and come back and forth. All right. So it's completely welded in. All butt welded in or spot welded in up on top. This is all welded in. I'm going to go back now and clean it all with the wire wheel first. Make sure there's no porous holes. But you can see there's no heat. Nice, very, very light. We're going to get the metal real hot. It's nice. It's got the shape still. It's not warped. Okay, so gonna go clean it all up with the wire wheel and then hit it with the grinder and grind it all down flush and then see what's left to go. Alright, so all that looks good. It didn't look like I missed anything. So now I'm gonna switch over and grind it all flush and then clean it all up with the die grinder. Alright, I'm gonna do some grinding finally. See if we got power. Around. So basically we're going to get it to where it's like that. And then that's welded in. But it's nice and flush. There's no lip, no nothing, so we're good to go there. And then I'll come back and just fill in all these little holes, this gap. The rest of it's going to be already filled like that. I'll fill in this gap. This one's a little big. And then we'll go from there. All right. Man, all ground down. I'm gonna go back over it with the little grinder with this. Clean it up even better. And then we'll put a skim of Bondo on it, clean it all up and get it all ready to go. And then we start blocking. So we're working back on this line too. Now you can see it's got a nice net lip. I'm gonna fix this spot in here. And then fix this. And then when the rest of the hood gets done, we'll blend it right into it. So, coming along. All right, so working on this channel here, trying to get that lip. So we're gonna mix some more of this little plastic in here. And I put the tape in it so the Bondo doesn't get behind in the channel back here, because I already scraped all that out. I don't want to do that again. So we're going to just take a little bit of this and fill that in. It's looking good. That's it. Give that a little minute to, I'm gonna give it a little bit to just start to cure, and then I'll peel the tape back. And then that's ready to go. All right. That's that. I gotta clean that up tomorrow. A little spot right here. That's it. All right. And that's it for today. Another day down. I'm just going to peel that back. We'll be done with this today. That a minute. Just like that. Now this is nice and clean. And that stays in there. Just like so. And that's it. That's that part.